Active learning involves actively engaging with the content, with the learning material. It helps in the development of higher order of thinking, which involves reflection, which involves analysis and synthesis of the concepts and theoretical ideas that you're trying to comprehend. On the other hand, passive learning is everything that active learning is not. It will only allow you to develop superficial level understanding of the concepts that can at best help you in solving the plug and play type of questions if you come across them on your FE electrical or PE power exams. In my opinion, there are four very simple and straightforward, fundamental, but time-tested active learning style strategies. And during my one-on-one Zoom calls with my FE electrical and computer exam preparation students, as well as the PE power students who enroll in my course, I share these strategies. In this video, we are going to go over these four active learning style strategies in detail. But before we jump into the content, I would like to request you to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. Active learning style strategy number one is taking notes. So I recommend students that whenever they're using the course or the study guide or any other exam preparation resource for that matter, within my FE electrical and computer exam preparation course, there are 150 plus lectures that cover the entire specification for FE electrical and computer exam. So when they're going through the lectures, I recommend them to absorb the theoretical concepts and make notes of the important or the significant things that they feel that they should remember. So these are your personalized notes that are going to help you retain those concepts that you feel are important. This does two things for you. It helps you to sort of take a break during your study session, but this is not a break to go off on a tangent, to start WhatsApping or Instagramming or anything like that. This break is for reflection. This break will allow you to sort of very quickly rewind what you've learned. And when you're taking notes, in my opinion, something magical happens. It has served me well throughout my academic career in undergraduate engineering studies, in graduate engineering studies, during high school, and even now when I'm learning anything new, because it really helps with retention and the process of putting your thoughts from your brain to a piece of paper helps, in my opinion, some sort of reorganization happens in your mind, and you're able to sort of compartmentalize that knowledge piece in an orderly manner. Otherwise, you listen, you retain something, and the rest of it basically just flies off. But when you write it down, you are essentially capturing the idea much more effectively, and you can recall it later on when you need it during the exam or while connecting the dots when you're learning something new. There's a difference between memorization and taking notes that are important based on your own observation. Memorization is helpful and it is a great skill to have, but it is not necessary for FE electrical and computer exam. In fact, I strongly recommend students to become more familiar with the reference handbook than trying and wasting their time in memorizing the equations. So let me give you an example. Let's say you're going through the three-phase circuit analysis lecture series in the course, or you're doing problem sets from any other exam preparation resources that you're using. Now, there will be a bunch of equations that will come up repeatedly. In your notes, what should go is basically not the Y to delta transformation. It is not the equation for line voltage, line current to phase current, or a bunch of other equations that are provided in the three-phase circuit portion of the NCEES FE reference handbook under electrical and computer engineering. But the idea is that when you're solving the problems, when you're going through the lecture, you're making notes that can help you understand those subtle concepts. Why is there a 30 degree phase shift? What is the purpose of the square root 3? What does that conjugate mean when you're looking at apparent power, when you're looking at complex power? How does real power how is the real power related to apparent power, and how is the reactive power related to real power? Power factor, what does that really mean? Draw that power factor right angle triangle and try and comprehend that. Make some notes. So that's the whole idea. Memorization is not required for FE electrical and computer exam, in my opinion. And if you were to choose between memorization and the familiarization with the handbook, I would recommend you spend more time on getting familiar with the handbook. But notes taking is very important, as I said. This will help you increase your retention of the concept, how the different concepts interplay, and how you can actually apply the knowledge that you're learning in order to solve the problems. The second active learning style strategy involves avoiding the temptation to look at the solutions when you're going through the problem sets and when you're doing the quizzes within the course or when you're doing the practice exams. Any resources that you're using, don't just go directly to the solutions after looking at the problems. I know some students do that, and during my coaching calls with students, I strongly advise against it, especially when you're going through your first round of review, because it is the time to reflect upon what you really understand and what you don't understand. And there's a lot to be said about that frustration that you encounter when you're learning something new. It is part of the learning process. It is going to frustrate you. It is going to annoy you. But during that process of trying to figure things out, trying to look at a problem and thinking about how to approach it, whether you should go from the left or the right, from the center, from the top, it actually helps you develop that framework, the conceptual understanding that is necessary for passing this exam. Because if you were to fool yourself literally by looking at the solution and telling yourself that, you know what, I would have arrived at this solution, you're actually being not 100% transparent and honest to yourself. Because you might be able to do that during your exam preparation mode, but on the day of exam, there's no solution that you can look at. And it will essentially be very detrimental for the end goal. So keep the end goal in mind. The end goal is to pass the exam. The end goal is not to make your study sessions easy. Initially, when the study sessions are tough, when you're going through this frustration, and a lot of this can be alleviated by making use of good exam preparation resources that are going to help you understand those concepts in a streamlined manner. But regardless, don't try and run away from the frustration and annoyance that is encountered while doing active learning, while looking at the problems, understanding the solutions, and when going through the solutions, even the correct solution or even incorrect solution, think about why this particular solution is not applicable and think about why the solution that is there is the correct one. Active learning strategy number three involves thinking about how a given problem can be asked in different ways. Conversely, looking at a solution and the problem and asking yourself how I could have solved this particular problem in a correct manner, but using a different approach. And this is something that I highly recommend students who are taking math, electrical and computer course and who interact with me. I tell them that whenever you are looking at a circuit analysis problem, as an example, try and solve it in 4 to 5 different ways. For example, try and solve it using KVL, using KCL, Thevenin theorem, Norton theorem, superposition. So for a given problem, maybe not all of these options would be applicable, but try and use as many approaches as you can. And when you're looking at a problem, see how that problem could have been asked differently. Lionel Messi is one of the greatest soccer players of all time. Similarly, Roger Federer is also an all-time tennis great. I recently read an article in The Economist where Federer was quoted praising Lionel Messi, saying that there always seems to be 3 different options for him, and he's one of the few who actually has that. I'm paraphrasing it. So what he's saying is that whenever Messi is approaching the goal post, there seems like there are 3 different ways he can score the goal. This is the approach that we want to take when we're preparing for the FE electrical and computer exam. We're not trying to necessarily ace this exam, but we want to be able to pass this exam comfortably. In the same article, they mentioned that Roger Federer scans the tennis court many times more than an average tennis player would. Similarly, Lionel Messi, he scans the field, he turns left, right, all the time, much more than an average player would basically do. So they are contemplating, reflecting, and thinking what's really going on. They are in an immersive and active state. They are engaging with the task at hand. And this is exactly what we need to do. Active learning strategy number 4 is learning from first principles. Elon Musk, the founder of Tesla, SpaceX, and a bunch of other revolutionary companies, is several times quoted saying, you can actually check out multiple YouTube videos where he says that he's a big fan of learning from first principles. Now, learning from first principles basically mean that you are creating the theoretical concepts and the framework of the underlying concept from ground up. You're not simply just copying what is done over here or taking someone's word for how things are. You're basically going step by step from zero all the way to building that conceptual skyscraper in your mind. Now, I understand that learning from first principle is not always easy. It is very difficult. And a lot of students take the easy approach, which is, okay, give me the equation, tell me the formula, let me know what's known and what's unknown, and I will give you the answer. But it will only get you so far. It will only apply to the plug and play type of problems. But if the problem is theoretical, if it has curveballs in it, then it can very quickly disarm you. So the key over here is to understand the concept. And my personal approach within my field electrical and computer exam, as well as the P power exam, is that the more difficult a concept is, the more detail I go into, the more effort I put in order to explain it. Now, the converse is true. I find a lot of students trying to take the easy route when the more challenging the concept is. They think that, okay, you know what, for this particular challenging concept, maybe if a question comes, I'm just going to bypass it. But when enough of those concepts accumulate, it can make a lot of difference between you passing and failing the exam. In my PE Power course, I actually do a lot of derivations of the fundamental equations and formulas and concepts. Not necessarily so much in my FE Electrical course, because there's a lot of ground to cover. But for the most convoluted concepts, such as Bayes' theorem, I actually derived the whole thing from scratch. And initially, students may find it a little bit challenging to comprehend that. But when they go through it step-by-step manner and follow the explanations, do the practice problems, they will have a deep understanding of such a complicated concept, and they can handle any question that is thrown at them. In summary, if you want to pass the FE Electrical and Computer exam comfortably in your first attempt, I strongly recommend you to adopt the active learning style, the four strategies that we discussed in this video. Strategy number one was pausing during your study sessions to take notes. Strategy number two was to avoid the temptation to look at the solutions while you're solving the problems. Try and solve the problems as much as you can before jumping into the solutions. Strategy number three was to think about different ways a particular problem can be asked, and to think about different ways you can solve a given problem. And the last but not the least is learning from first principles. I understand that this particular strategy is demanding, it is challenging, and it is not very practical to apply on every single knowledge area, because otherwise you won't be able to prepare for the exam. There are 17 sections for FE Electrical and Computer exam, and a whole lot of content to cover for the PE Power exam as well. But I recommend you deploying this strategy whenever you're learning something which forms the foundation of a particular knowledge area, when you're learning something that you know that will come again and again. So if you spend time and learn it from the first principles right now, it will pay you dividends in the future.